An implementation of a set needs a way to test the equality of elements so that an element is not put into the set twice. For now, we rely on function equals in class object, so that a set may contain only objects that do not override function equals. Thus, x.equals y is true if and only if x and y are the same object. The implementation will also use a function called hashCode in class object. For object x, x.hashCode returns the address in memory of x as an integer. We now describe the basic data structure. We have an array B, shown here with 9 elements, each element of which is declared to be a linked list. So, each element of B is either null or an object of class linked list. In this context, array elements B sub H are called buckets. The set being implemented consists of the elements in all the linked lists. Note that no element appears more than once in all these linked lists. That's all there is to it. We now develop most of the code for add, showing the addition of object E1 to the empty set as an example. Remember, E1 is actually a pointer to an object, not the object itself. Method add of E returns false if E is already in the set and true if E was not in the set and was added. The big question is, to which of the 9 buckets B sub 0 dot dot 8 should E be added to? The answer: calculate the remainder H when E dot hashCode is divided by the length of B, and then use bucket B sub H. Integer 8, based on the address where E is stored in memory, is rather random. This randomness will give us, when we're done, order 1 expected time for add and remove. If B of H is null, create a new empty list and store it in B sub H. Next, if linked list B sub H contains E, E is already in the set and false is returned. Finally, if E was not in B sub H, add it. Consider attempting to add object E1 again, calling add E1. Again, H is set to 5. Element B sub H is not null. This time, the linked list contains E1 and false is returned. We show what the data structure might look like with 6 elements in buckets 2, 5, and 7. The next video describes what to do when the set becomes too full, that is, when the linked lists get too long.